Although suicide bombing first appeared among Lebanon Shia Muslims, I heard of another Lebanese group for whom it was just a battlefield tactic. For the members of the Syrian Socialist National Party, religion played no part. I met up with one of the party's leaders, Taufik Mahana.
Yeah. How many martyrs have you had in the party?
We have 13.
13. I mean, what goes through their heads? What I don't understand is, you know, if you're a Muslim or a Christian who believes in the afterlife of heaven and you want to commit martyrdom, you're promising me a future, what you believe in or you don't believe in. What do you promise these people for eternity? I mean, this is very strange, you understand, for me to understand.
The Muslim, for example, who goes through this kind of sacrifice, is promised by paradise. Our comrades are not promised by a paradise in heaven. Their paradise is on earth. Their country is their paradise.
For members of the SSNP, it was a purely political struggle. Each bomber would record a video will explaining why they were about to sacrifice their lives against the Israeli invader. Being a secular party, there was no ban on the use of women. Half of the SSNP martyrs were female, including the world's first female suicide bomber, 17-year-old Sana Muhaidli.
I ask all my family and all those close to me to carry on along my path of sacrifice until the complete liberation of our land. I want you to rejoice for me because my soul is going home. I am giving myself for the honor of my people. So I hope that you are not sad, for this is my wedding day.
On the 9th of April, 1985, Sanaa drove a car into an Israeli patrol and blew herself up, killing two soldiers. She became known as the Bride of the South. The party arranged for me to meet a veteran commander. He's still nervous about talking, as for years he was hunted by the Israelis.
There's no one listening in on us, is there?
No.
When we're talking.
Munir al-Jamali personally organized the attack of another female suicide bomber, Norma Abi Hassan.
One day she came to me and said, "Munir, I want to carry out an operation against Israel." I said, "It's wrong that you go and die. It's wrong." She said, "It's what I want. My mother is no good. My father drinks and smokes. He's no good." She had lived with the party for 6 months. She had seen people dying, people going on acts of martyrdom. So she said that she now wanted to go on an operation herself. No one pressurized her.
On the 17th of July, 1986, Norma drove a car into an Israeli army base and blew herself up, killing 10 Israeli soldiers. She was 26 years old.
Norma was beautiful. She gave me this picture before she committed her act of martyrdom. On the back, she wrote me a message that said, "I am going now."
Ila Rafiq Mir Hamali, Norma Abi Hassan, Zalba
Norma.
Hello.
Zalba Norma.
She was a really good person, a real gem.
The Lebanese.